time for the MT-07. Sounds much milder. The clutch lever is very, very high. You have to let it out very far to actually ride. It's quite nimble. Less scarier. Actually not scary at all, it feels like I've been driving this thing for 5 years. Your riding position is very familiar, and my GS doesn't have this riding position, so it's just a natural riding position. Was a little jumpier than the one on the MC09. I didn't know this road, so that's good. Now I do. It's always good to ride with somebody who has a little bit more experience in the area. The only thing this thing needs is an aftermarket exhaust. Without a decibel killer. I mean, this thing is not bad, but it's... Well, it's a little bit more than a starter's bike, but... When you've been riding a starter bike for 2 years, 3 years, this one... going to seem like it's not that much, especially when you've just driven a MT-09. But it's a brilliant bike. Again, riding position is just like the MT-09, very straight up, which will be good on your wrists and lower back. But because it's a naked bike, you have quite a lot of grip resistance. The MT-09 I just drove, it had a little screen. Well, I didn't drive it at this speed, but it didn't seem like I had that much trouble. Having trouble speaking as well. Jesus. It's crazy. Well, it's a turn. Slow down. The brakes are a little less powerful as well. ride this bike, you can, well, if you have enough experience on a beginner's bike, like 2 or 3 years, like I just said, you're going to have the feeling that you can ride this bike at its limits in like 1 year. I mean, it's faster than my bike. My opinion has been corrupted because I drove the M209, which is a superior bike, and well, I don't know, probably twice as much money. Twice as much money, and you're twice as likely to crash on it, so that's a thing. And it's twice as easy to do a wheelie on it as well. You can do power wheelies easily. I'm not sure about this thing. Camera's still rolling, which is a good thing, at least as far as I know. Maybe it's, no, it's still there. That's good. That's good, that's good, that's good. Now let's see how it does in the twisties, shall we? When it's under 2000 or 3000 RPMs, it's basically quiet. I keep thinking I'm stalling. Holy smokes. Yeah, you can definitely ride this at the limit. I never hit the rev limiter on my bike. Feels very solid though, doesn't it? Well, that's a very basic thing to say about a bike, that it's solid. About 4.5, at about 4.5 RPMs, it starts to rumble. And at 6000, it really gets going. Sun. It's the only thing I need right now. Handles better than my bike, that's for sure. Feels like it's part of you. Jesus, I'm just saying things right now. Don't need.
Always egg snore.
You probably hate motorcycle riders.
Oh, those guys there are going to kill themselves with their riding style.
Sounds more like a grandma without teeth, but still. And then you have these stupid wannabe Tour de France mother idiots there's a bicycle path over there, and they keep riding on a road, which keeps us from having fun. I mean, it's not allowed to ride here, but still. I can tell you, if I drove the M209 here, I would probably crash. But the M207 is perfect for it. A little less power, a little lighter handling. It's perfect for small corners. Perfect city bike, but I would prefer the MC09 for daily riding. It's just an all-round better bike. Okay guys, little conclusion. If you want a bike that scares you, don't buy this. If a bike that you want to ride and you have not that much experience and you just like riding an easy bike, buy this one. It's just an easy bike right after you had a startup. Easy to ride, you won't crash that fast. But if you have the cash, and if you want more speed, buy the MC09. It's just more fun all around. And you will get less bored with it over time. So that's my final conclusion. Thanks for watching and enjoy some of the last curves before I end this video. I will see you in the next video. Bye bye. using a lot of petrol. You want some more?